2020 ethics case studies were a little lengthier. At least two case studies were very big, and given you are supposed to allocate not more than 15 minutes to write a case study, because within 1.5 hour you are expected to finish the 6 case studies, and in the next 1.5 hour you are supposed to write the questions. Even I don't reducing the time not more than 1 hour 15 minutes, you should not cross, because the questions takes lot amount of time, because there are so many questions that you have to write. So this is the trickiest part in this year's ethics paper, that the case studies were a little lengthier. So your grasping and your consciousness and how your attentiveness is clearly tested here. So with this, we'll start this first case study. So this is a very lengthy case study. I've split into two slides. So try to be conscious here. Rajesh Kumar is a senior public servant with a reputation of honesty and forthrightness, and currently posted in the finance ministry as the head of the budget division. His department is presently busy in organizing budgetary support to the states, now four of which are due to polls within the financial year. Now you please remember this, four states are due to go for polls. So there will be most probably an election code. Once the election code is there, you cannot spend money in that constituency. So this is the basic formula that you all of you know. Now, this year's annual budget has allocated 8,300 crores for the National Housing Scheme, a centrally sponsored social housing scheme for the weaker sections of the society. Now, out of this, some 775 crores has been drawn for the NHS till June. So budget, of once it is stable and within the first 3 months, April, May, June, so 775 crores have been spent. Now, the Ministry of Commerce had long been pursuing a case for setting up a special economic zone in a southern state to boost exports. Now, in the second paragraph, it stated that the central government has launched this housing scheme and it has allocated this amount of money. Out of this, this amount has already been drawn. So you can assume that roughly there are another 7,500 crores is left here. Now, this Ministry of Commerce has, for a long period of time, it has been pursuing for setting up a CESS in a southern state to boost export. Now, after 2 years of detailed discussion between the center and state, the Union Cabinet has approved the project in August. The process was initiated to acquire the necessary land. Now, first of all, you please remember that the second paragraph, it is talking about something called welfare, that is roti, kapda, makan. You call something called the, something like housing. So these are the basic necessities for the survival. Now, whereas the third paragraph is something this is talking about a development, that is the CESS may boost about exports. At the same time, it may give employment or export. This is something, the second step. So these are, the second paragraph is talking about something, the very basic need for survival. Whereas third paragraph is a step forward. Now look at this fourth paragraph. 18 months ago, now in the second, just before going to the fourth paragraph, you can see that in the third paragraph, the government, the cabinet has approved for setting up the CESS. Now, it has also given permission for the acquisition of necessary land, but you can say that, you can assume that the land acquisition has not yet been started. This is the basic thing you need to remember. So for acquiring the land, at least there might be some amount of visiting the field, talking with the people, it takes some amount of time. So you need to recognize this fact, or you need to assume this, that okay, the government has sanctioned assess, it has called for acquiring the land, but the process has not yet started. So to acquire the land and to pay the money to the people, at least it takes 1 year or not. Just imagine, acquiring land in India is not a small issue. Now, 18 months ago, a leading PSU had projected the need for setting up a large natural gas processing plant in a northern state for the regional gas grid. The land is already in possession of the PSU. The gas grid is an essential component of the national energy security strategy. After 3 rounds of global bidding, the project was allocated to an MNC. So and so MNC. the first tranche of payment to the MNC is scheduled to be made in the December. So if you are making the payment in the December of this year, so this money has to be drawn from the current budget itself. So you have to clear that. So you cannot draw money from somewhere else, though it may be an extra budgetary allowance or an additional budgetary allowance, but it has to be made from this budget itself.
Sorry.
Now, the finance ministry was asked for a timely allocation of additional 6,000 crores for these two development projects. Now, here in the National Housing Scheme, there are 7,500 crores left since 775. I am roughly speaking, since 775 has already been drawn. Now, here the finance ministry is asking for 6,000 crores. So in the housing project, we are left with 7,500. So if the 6,000 grows here, it will be another 1,500 left. It was decided to recommend reappropriation of this entire amount from NHS allocation. Now, what is the advice is that you take this entire money from the housing scheme that where we have allocated that 8,300 crores. Since there is only around 775 crores has been spent. Now, the file was forwarded to the budget department for their comments and the further processing. On studying the case file, the Rajesh Kumar realized that reappropriation means taking money from one allocation to another allocation, may cause inordinate delay in the execution of this housing project, a much publicized in the rallies of the senior politicians. See, correspondingly, non-availability of finances would cause financial losses in the CESS and national embarrassment due to delayed payment in the international project. Now, Rajesh Kumar discussed the matter with the seniors. He was conveyed that this politically sensitive situation needs to be processed immediately. Rajesh Kumar realized that diversion of funds from the NHS could raise difficult questions for the government in the parliament. Now, discuss the following with reference to this case. Ethical issues involved in the reappropriation of funds from the welfare project to the developmental projects. Given the need for proper utilization of public funds, discuss the options available to the Rajesh Kumar. Is resigning a worthy option? See, the case, at least reading and glancing itself, it takes minutes of time. Now you are left with another 6 minutes to write this case study. So remember how conscious you have to be and how quickly you have to pick the facts as well as the relevant data that you need to quote in the answer. Now, let us see how to solve this. See, I will introduce something like this. See, budget, it is nothing but the balancing the revenues and expenditure. A difficult task for a civil servant, especially for a developing country like India. Why? Because we have many needs and necessities, whereas the finances are less since we are a developing nation. So it is a test to the civil servant. What does it will test? It will test my attitude and aptitude, that is problem solving skills, as well as my approach towards the problem. Now, after this intro, you can write certain facts if you want, and you can write the stakeholders. I'm not mentioning those here. Now, ethical issues involved in the reappropriation of funds. I'm addressing this first question here. See, my superiors have advised me a certain direction. If I go by that, I'm upholding obedience and loyalty. But if I go by their advice, then I may not put my wisdom and integrity into testing. See, an individual is expected to act according to his wisdom and integrity. At the same time, since it is a politically sensitive issue, what one expects from me is loyalty. But at the same time, my objectivity in decision making or impartial decision making or non-partisan decision making is what required from a civil servant. Now, here, housing is something which is talking about inclusiveness. That the remaining two projects talk about overall economic development. That is, more often it is talking about employment or raising the income of the people. So I can say that it is nothing but a welfare state or socialism versus capitalism or economic development. So these are the ethical issues or ethical dilemmas that Rajesh Kumar faces in this case study. Now, what are the options available? First option, divert the entire money as asked. Now, if for every option, you can simply state the merit and demerit. See, if you are diverting the entire amount, the housing project will be delayed. Housing is a basic necessity of the people. It is a basic welfare project of the people, and that gets delayed. So that is a demerit. But by diverting, you are being loyal to your superiors. You are being loyal to the political executives. You are being loyal to the superiors. So you are displaying the quality of loyalty and obedience. Now, divert 2/3 with 1/3 for each project. So here the second option talks about is that instead of diverting entire amount, you split the amount into 3 parts and you allocate this 1/3 part into 2 projects. So this is one way of diverting. Or see, here in the first paragraph, we have seen that 4 states are going to elections plus a small fraction to CES. Why? Because here, since election code is there, since only a small fraction to CES. Why? Because remember here, only a small fraction is required here to CES, because since the land acquisition has only started now. So in order to acquire the land, in order to make the payment, it takes some amount of time. So I can buy some amount of time here. So I am allocating only small amount to CES. So here I am left with certain additional amount. Here also, since 4 states are going to elections, since there is election code, I cannot spend that amount there. So I am left with some more amount. I use these 2 amounts to the gas project. So this is one way of providing an option. Or seeking an extra budgetary support. Since gas projects are developmental projects, try for going for a PPP or loans. Since these are development projects, you can acquire a loan from bank, or you can float an option of public-private partnership where a private sector can bring some amount of capital. Or you can choose an option of corporate social responsibility funds for this housing scheme. But if all these 3, 4, 5, 6 options fail, 3, 4, 5, and 6 options fail, allocate less for CES. Since land acquisition takes much more time, that's with small amount of money, it can carry forward. Since a bulk amount of payment has to be made to the gas project by December, allocate more to it and maintain that minimum sufficient amount for NHS so that this housing project doesn't stop. So these are the few options that you can expect. But given that 6 to 7 minutes of time and thinking these many options is what is tested in an individual in that examination environment. Even I myself, I took more than half an hour to write these options. So this is not an easy task for me also. So you try to practice these kind of very lengthy case studies whenever you get, and try to solve it in a shorter amount of time so that you also get acclimatized when you face that similar kind of case studies in the examination. See, while teaching, I have these many options, but it took me hell amount of time to decode this case study and put these many options on paper. So don't take from my side that I have done this something miracle and presenting to you. So it took me a lot of time to decode this case study. So how to cope up with these kind of case studies? Only thing, practice a case study for one case study one day, so that any case study, if you get of this much amount of length, you can write it in an easier manner. And finally, the question also says that resigning itself is not worthy. Why? Because winners don't quit. So this is the way you have to write this case study. Hope you have understood. If you have any doubts with respect to this case study, please raise your doubts in the chat box. Ashok, Kushbu, Palomi, Rahul, if you have any doubts with respect to this case study. Yeah. We'll start with the second case study. Even this case study is also a little bit lengthy.